Hello, everyone. Hey, it's starting to show up on a sad note. We've had some definite losses over these past few days, and gotta pay tribute accordingly. Who's that, you say? This wonderful lady, Alice Dixon, African American, oldest. They believe she was the oldest living female veteran. Yep, oldest living female veteran, war veteran, army veteran. Alice Dixon, born September 11th, 1907. She passed away at the ripe old age of 108 years old, January 27th, 2016. A sad loss, but what a life she lived. A good long life indeed. 108, hey, ain't nothing wrong with passing away at the age of 108. Not in the least bit. This one is sad, though. This is tragic. This man right here, his name is Barry Coates. Barry Coates, now, he passed away from cancer. And he was born May 23rd, 1969, passed away January 23rd, only 46 years old. Now, he was involved, unfortunately. Now, we love the VA, Veterans Administration, what they do for veterans, past, present, future. But unfortunately, he had to wait so long to be seen for appointments and stuff that he passed away, basically. He was kind of neglected. Very sad, very tragic. Big VA scandal. He spoke out heavily against him. And Barry Coates sadly lost his life much too young, only 46 years old. Cancer is so evil. And then this man right here, not well known in the United States, but definitely a legend in France. One of those 1950s French filmmakers, an icon in France. This is Jacques Divette. D-I-V-E-T-T-E. Jacques Divette, born March 1st, 1928. He passed away January 29, 2016. 87 years old. French film director. One of the many that were legends in France. So a sad loss there. But hey, 87 ain't a bad way to go, folks. Now, Jefferson Airplane, Jefferson Starship, incredible band formed, I believe, in 1965. They lost a couple of their legends on the same day. Jefferson Airplane, Jefferson Starship, definitely crushed. Crushing blow. Paul Kantner, one of the original co-founders of Jefferson Airplane and a huge icon. Paul Kantner, born March 17, 1941. He passed away at the age of 74 on January 28, 2016. He is definitely going to be sorely missed. Jefferson Airplane, Starship, he was with them from the beginning and right on up until the end. Paul Kantner, sad loss indeed. And finally, she was the original lead singer for Jefferson Airplane, 1965 and 66. That is Signe Anderson. You didn't hear a lot about her. You heard a lot more about Grace Slick, who took over, because Signe Anderson got pregnant, had a kid, and she decided to leave the band to be a mom, and she never looked back, never went back. Signe Anderson, born September 15th, 1941. She also passed away January 28, 2016. The original lead singer of Jefferson Airplane, Signe Anderson. So moment of silence, please, for those Fab Five and Paul Kantner. What a huge loss indeed. All right, well, folks, I'll tell you, January 2016 has got to have been the worst month in the history of famous deaths, celebrity deaths. It's just been an awful, awful month. Let's hope things are much better. In the meantime, folks, we got a show to do. We got a party to live it up. Because hell yeah, that's right. Hang on. Thought I had it set up. I guess not. Ha ha ha. Here we go. Ah, crap. There we go. Hello, everyone. It is indeed Sunday, January 31st in the year of our Lord, 2016. How are all you doing out there? I am doing awesome as always. Wicked awesome. It's football Sunday. Now, I know today's the Pro Bowl, but what I've decided to do, last week we honored the Game of the Week being the AFC Championship game. You got to give respect to the NFC Championship game. Absolutely. Arizona Cardinals at the Carolina Panthers. We all know what happened. We all know the Cardinals got crushed. By God, they were in the game, and that's a lot better than any other NFC team could say, with the exception of the Carolina Panthers. So out of respect I gotta represent the NFC with my favorite football player of all time, Barry the Man Sanders, number 20, Detroit Lions jersey. And of course, still gotta represent my New England Patriots because I'm a Patriots fan for life, through thick and thin. There you go. That's it. And today's holidays. Hey, it's National Backwards Day. Maybe I should have worn my jersey backwards. Nah, screw that. That's just weird. National Backwards Day. Bass Ackwards, I like to call it. And then it is also, definite tree hugger day right here. National Inspire Your Heart with Art Day. Actually, I know a professional artist, a very dear friend of mine. My dear friend, Brooke Olson. Brooke, that one's for you, sweetheart. National Inspire Your Heart with Art Day. And she's a very inspirational friend, a very inspirational sweetheart of a lady. Very dear friend of mine. For life, Brooke Olson. That's for you, my friend. Much love to you. From yours truly, the love, Dr. Reverend Dr. B. Oh, yeah. Well, folks, today's unofficial sponsor of our show. Give it up to my good friend Will Coogan and his phenomenal business, the Wharf Restaurant and Pub, Eggertown, Massachusetts. We filled beer and song of the day there once, back on February 11, 2013. Of course, it's Martha's Vineyard Island, a great place. Great place for fantastic service, fantastic food, fantastic adult beverages. The Wharf Restaurant and Pub, Eggertown, Massachusetts. If you're on Martha's Vineyard, you better take yourself over there and go say hi to Will as well. Incredible folks over there. All right, well, I'm parched. Bust out the New England Patriots beer consumption apparatus, and I got a new beer to feature. I'm excited about this one, so I better give my good friends over to Philo Liquor some love, because they let me know about it a long time ago. Yeah, Philo Liquors, folks. Can't pick a better place to get quality adult beverages when you're in good old Abilene, Yeehaw, Texas. Philo Liquors, love you, folks, and thank you so much. Give me first dibs on this one. I'm so excited about this. Rahr & Sons Brewing Company, they are abso-freaking-smurfalutely phenomenal out of Fort Worth, Texas. And this beer is a beast. It's their 11th anniversary beer, and it's a Russian Imperial Stout with toasted coconut. It's a whopping 9% alcohol by volume, 22 ounces of beast. I'm excited. I'm pumped up. Prop beer winning apparatus, prop technique. Here we go. Man. 45 degree anger right in the big substance apparatus, right over the keyboard, because I'm sad, damn good. Haven't spilled a drop yet, never have, never will. Dude, dark and delicious. My God, look at this thing. It looks like motor oil. Ha ha! Oh, man. This is my kind of beer right here, folks. I hope it's as good as I think it's going to be. We shall see. Cheers to beers, all of you. Pro said Jeremy Kapayas, San Japan. Oh, my God. Oh my God, that, my friends, is pure perfection. That's an A-plus all the way. This Russian Imperial Stout is incredibly smooth, full of robust flavor, and that coconut that makes it sweeter. Oh, wow. All right, well, we got a bunch of birthdays from yesterday and today. Let's get cracking. Right off the bat yesterday, my good friend Matt Erickson. This guy, the pride of Wichita, Kansas, that's right. Matt Erickson, we got some mutual friends of Wichita. Awesome stuff. And happy milestone birthday to you from yesterday. What's going on with you, big guy? How you doing? Hope you're doing well. Hope you enjoyed the show. Hope you had a phenomenal birthday yesterday. And hope you celebrate some more today. So, hey, live it up. Happy milestone birthday to you, Matt. Hope you have a wicked awesome day. Celebrate well and enjoy. Cheers and beers. Next on the list. My man, Nate Kittles, Nathanius Kittles. Now, here's a badass crew, dog, and an incredible leader of men, women, and nits that I know from good old California, the land of fruits and nuts, otherwise known as Southern Oregon. Nate, what's up, my brother from another mother? How you doing? Hope you're doing well. Hope your birthday was incredible yesterday. Looks like it was. Couldn't expect anything less from you. Hell of a guy. Definitely miss working with you on the job site. But, Nate, happy birthday from yesterday, brother, and a big cheers of beers. Next on the list, my good friend, Ryan Williams. Now, here's another badass, hardworking mamma jamma and a great leader of men, women, and it's that I know right down here in Yeehaw, Texas. Otherwise known as Southern Oklahoma, pretty much the same damn state. Ryan, what's up with you, big guy? How you doing? Hope you're doing well. Hope your birthday yesterday was absolutely phenomenal. I hope you had a wicked piss-up birthday. How about that, huh? There you go. Well, Ryan, happy birthday, my man. And a big cheers of beers. Mm. Warning, I'm probably not going to be sober by the time I'm done with this show. Next on the list, my good friend, Gretchen Wien. An ageless wonder. Well, duh, she's from Martha's Vineyard Island, of course, where we don't age. And Gretchen, an absolutely gorgeous sweetheart of a lady and a fine outstanding graduate of Martha's Vineyard Ridge High School class of 1991. That's right, the best damn graduating class in the history of mankind, womankind, and it kind. And Gretchen, an absolute sweetheart, a very dear friend. Happy birthday from yesterday. Like I'd forget, right? You know that. I hope you're doing well, and I hope you have another wicked awesome day today. So live it up, and celebrate well, and enjoy, and cheers to mercy, my dear. Hell yeah. Final birthday from yesterday. An incredible leader of men, women, and it's. Did I know from Jolly Old England? This guy is awesome. My man, Robert Ricks. That's right, Robert Ricks, an incredible man. Who, remember almost 5 years ago now? Oh my God, it's well over 4.5 years ago now. Oh yeah, remember that? We went to Bible camp together. We found God, learned lots of scripture. Hey, we did learn about some good adult beverages too now, didn't we? Yes, we did. Well, Robert, great hearing from you yesterday. Always a pleasure chatting with you. And happy birthday from yesterday, my man. Hope you had a wicked awesome day. Méchant Janine, French for wicked awesome. You know what I'm saying, eh? That's what I'm talking about. Oh, get it indeed. You got to get some loved one names up north, and I do that on Baron Song of the Day every single day of the week. Beanie. Robert, happy birthday from yesterday, my man, and a big cheers of beers to you. Mm. All right. Those are yesterday's birthdays, my friends. How about today's birthdays? Oh, yeah. Now, here's a stunningly gorgeous sweetheart of a lady and a badass crew dog that I work with down here in Yeehaw, Texas, otherwise known as West Louisiana. She's a stunner. She's awesome. Celebrating a milestone birthday today. 25, man alive, the perfect age. That's right, Tia Meredith. Tia Meredith, Tia Gonzalez, an absolute sweetheart. A very dear friend of mine, a former Real Baby Today on Baron Song of the Day, and there's Princess Delilah. That's right, Tia, happy milestone birthday to you. Hey, that's right, 25 is perfect age. You know what that means? You can rent the car from the airport now. You can already drink adult beverages. Your insurance goes down. And you can go to triple X-rated adult porn flicks if you so choose. You can already do that anyway. Hi. Well, Tia, I hope Lou's spawning you well. Because your lady is an absolute goddess like you. Hell yeah, another former Real Baby Today on Beer Song Today. Hi, Lou. Hi, Tia. Happy birthday to you, Tia. Hope you have a wicked awesome day and party hard and enjoy. Celebrate like it's 1969 minus the acid. And cheers and beers to you, my dear.
If I look like I just woke up, it's because I did.
Yeah, you slept all night and all day. Yeah, lazy. How you gonna fall asleep tonight?
Melatonin.
Okay, you better. Good to see you, Princess Delilah, of course. Without her, life is almost worthless. All right, next on the list. My absolutely wicked awesome aunt. My aunt Nancy. Nancy Leck. Aunt Nancy, happy birthday to you. The pride of Pepperell, Massachusetts. Oh, yeah. But hey, originally from Barnstable, just like my mom. Oh, no kidding, they're sisters. Well, I'm Nancy. Always great hearing from you. And I hope you're having a phenomenal birthday. Love you. Miss you. Always great hearing from you. And happy birthday. And by golly, a big cheers and beers to you. Oh, squeeze me. Hi, Nancy. You're absolutely awesome. And I've known you my entire life, ever since I was a fetus. Wow. Crazy. Hey, you know my mom, I... Our entire life. Imagine that. You've known her longer than I have. All right. Our next birthday. It's a wonderful mafia on the old Mafia Wars. My good friend, Lori. Is it Cirley? C-I-R-L-E-Y or is it Curly? I am not sure. Lori, L-O-R-I-E. I like that spelling. Very cool. Lori Cirley, Mafia Wars legend. Happy birthday to you. And how you doing? I hope you're doing well. I hope you're having a phenomenal birthday. Getting spoiled rotten. You earn it. You deserve it. Live it up. Lori, happy birthday, my friend. And a big cheers of beers. Hmm. Next on the list. A wonderful mafioso on the old Mafia Wars. My man, Adolph Don Capone. That's a hell of a name right there, huh? A mafia Don. Evil and Capone. Mafia. Wow. Well, hey, it's Mafia Wars. You got to be a tough guy. And Adolph Don Capone, no doubt about it, you're a hell of a tough guy. It's great having you and my Mafia Wars crew. We get stronger by helping each other out so that we can crush the opposition. It's a lot of fun, but nobody gets hurt for real. Adolf Don Capone, happy birthday, my man. And a big cheers and beers. Next on the list. Now, he's going by the name of Carl Kurasinski on the old Facebook. But I've been talking to this guy for many years. Buffalo Sports Now. BSN, baby. This guy is awesome. Big time working hardcore. Legit no-bo Buffalo Bills fan. Buffalo Sabres fan. I can never remember if it's Buffalo Sports Now or Buffalo Sabres Now. Either way, it's probably both for you. And dude, what's up with you, man? How you doing? Hope you're doing well. Definitely missed the good times on the video cast and the podcast. Good stuff with the legend Sal Capaccio. And, of course, the late, great Johnny Vaughn. Definitely missed that guy dearly. I know you do, too. Well, BSN, my man, happy birthday. And I hope you have a wicked awesome day. And celebrate well and enjoy. And cheers and beers. Next on the list. Born the exact same month, day, and year as my friend BSN Carl Kurasinski, is the lovely, gorgeous, amazing Melissa Laurie. Now, I knew her as Melissa Mary, and she hooked up with this legend by the name of Harold Laurie. Brother Harold, that's right. And you know, they're high school sweethearts, and they got married after high school, and they're still married to this day, born 9 days apart. And Melissa, finally sitting grade on Martha Vineyard Reese High School class of 1991. Oh, hell yeah. Melissa, happy birthday to you. Like I'd forget, right? You don't have your birthday listed on Facebook. I don't need it. I've memorized it since the day I've known you. I've known you for over 2 decades. You're incredible. You're awesome. And I hope Harold's spoiling you rotten. I'm sure he is. He's a great guy. I miss you guys so much. Melissa, happy birthday to you, my friend. And a big cheers and beers. Next on the list, another wonderful mafia, Tanya Renee. Tanya, what's going on with you, my sister from another mister? How you doing? Hope you're doing well. And I hope you're getting spoiled rotten for your birthday, living it up, having a lot of fun. Hey, last day of the month, celebrate in style, right? I celebrate every day in style, and I think you should too. Well, Tanya, happy birthday. Always appreciate your help on the Mafia Wars. And I'll be cheers and beers to you. Oh, that was a good Super Bowl. Cardinals against the Steelers. Oh, it's just too bad the Steelers won that one. Arrgh. Corinne Bradley. Oh, what an absolute sweetheart of a lady I know from jolly old England. Married to an absolute legend, Keith. Oh, yeah. And I've known Keith forever. Corinne, happy birthday to you and great hear from you. And how are you? How you doing? Hope you're doing well. I hope Keith's spoiling you rotten for your birthday. I'm sure he is. He's a hell of a guy. And you're a hell of a lady. And miss the hell out of you big time. Miss hanging out with you guys. The Bradley family is absolutely wicked awesome. No doubt about that. Living down here in Yeehaw, Texas. All the way to Northern Mexico. Pretty much same damn country. Well, Corinne, happy birthday, my friend. And I hope you have a wicked awesome day. And celebrate well and enjoy. All right, cheers and beers to you, my dear. Hell yeah. All right. Let's go ahead and... there's that touchdown by my man Larry Fitzgerald. My second favorite NFL player of all time. Larry the Man Fitzgerald. Class act all the way. 23-20 Cardinals, 2:37 left, and we know what happened. The Steelers scored a touchdown at one. Ugh. Broke my heart. All right. That's it for the birthdays, my friends. Now, we've got ourselves a couple of really good trivia questions. And this first one was awesome. What U.S. state or territory is Arizona Cardinals guard Mike Iupati? I hope I pronounced that right. I-U-P-A-T-I.
Wow.
Excuse me. What U.S. state or territory is Mike Iupati a native of? Well, our good friend Matt Mad Dog Becker, another former Real Hunk of the Day on Beer and Song of the Day, I might add. And Matt, if you want to be featured again, you let me know. You said Samoa. And I'm like, okay, well, there's two of them. You got American Samoa and Western Samoa. So you guessed Western Samoa. And I said, no, it's not that one. So you know what happened? Your awesome son, Matt, chimed in. And Matt, You said America Samoa. Yeah, you did. And brother, you absolutely nailed it. Wicked awesome job. Hey, big. I love Dr. Salute to you. Oh, hell yeah. Matt, mini Matt, I guess. I don't know. You know what? That's a bell ringer. It's a bell ringer. The old man didn't get it, but you did. Hey, yeah, way to go, young man. Awesome stuff. And you know what? Cheers and apple juice to you. I don't think you're old enough for adult beverages. I don't remember. Actually, maybe you are. Mad Dog, you tell me. If your son's old enough for adult beverages, I say cheers and beers. If not, cheers and apple juice. Either way, wicked awesome job. All right. Now, I thought for sure somebody would get this one. The movie The Blind Side was about which Carolina Panthers football player? And I said, please note that he was not with the Panthers at the time that the movie was filmed. Well, Mad Mad Dog Becker, you had chimed in and said Michael, and you said that ironically you were watching the movie right then and there. But because you answered the other one, you should have answered it. You should have finished it off. It was Michael Oher, O-H-E-R. Man, oh man, nobody else gave it a shot. So, you know what? Shit, I'll drink to myself. All right, well, there you go. With that said, my God, do we have a lot of celebrity birthdays from yesterday and today. But before we do that, we're going to go ahead and bring out our vehicles, instruments, and pets of the day. That's the right thing to do. Let's start off with the Arizona Cardinals. And look at that Ford Mustang. Is that a beauty or what? Arizona Cardinals Ford Mustang, your Arizona Cardinals vehicle of the day on Beer and Song of the Day. Yeah, yeah. Carolina Panthers. Gotta give up the Panthers with another vehicle of the day here. And this one's a really cool one. It's wicked fast. Just like how fast the Panthers eliminated Arizona pretty much. Let's just be honest. That was a beatdown. About a Carolina Panthers IndyCar. Look at that beauty, huh? That's wicked fast right there. My goodness. That's a mighty fine automobile right there. I wouldn't mind having one of them. Can you imagine driving that on the road? Good God. Oh, instruments of the day, you say, eh? All right, well, Arizona Cardinals, it's hard to find an instrument for them, but a microphone's an instrument, and why not have a Arizona Cardinals microphone featuring Mike Iupati? That's really cool. I think so. I think you'll agree with that. Mike Iupati. And Arizona Cardinals microphone, your Arizona Cardinals instrument of the day on Beer and Song of the Day. Panthers instrument of the day. Well, you know what? This drum has actually been featured before, but I saw team owner Jerry Richardson beating the hell out of that drum. I'm like, dude, this is epic. That's awesome. When your team owner gets up there and beats the hell out of that drum, that's saying something. Keep pounding. And oh, they have been all season long, telling you. And Jerry Richardson, I love what this man did. He paid for all employees, any employee of the Carolina Panthers, paid their way to the Super Bowl in Santa Clara, California, where Super Bowl 50 is getting played. And what's even just as awesome as that, Denver Broncos decided to do the same thing. All their team employees are getting paid airfare, travel, whatever, to Santa Clara, California for Super Bowl 50. So, Broncos, Panthers, to the two of you, I'm giving you both a big, epic, love doctor salute. Ooh, hell yeah! Tell you what, I hope all team owners follow suit for that. From now on, whenever your team goes to the Super Bowl, you got the money there, team owners. Pay your way for all your employees so that they can be there for it. It's the right thing to do. That is class, baby. Epic class. I love it. Thank you, Jerry Richardson. You made it happen. Oh, look at that. Arizona Cardinals pet of the day. That's a beautiful collie right there. Lassie? Oh, I don't know about that, but Arizona Cardinals dog, you are pet of the day on Barron's Song of the Day. And how about a Carolina Panthers pet of the day? Now, I was going to bring out a Panther, but I'm waiting for the Super Bowl. So in the meantime, let's go ahead and bring out a Carolina Panthers dog. This was too cute to pass up. Look at that, will you? I don't know who owns that dog, but that is cute. And you got a Carolina Panthers helmet and jersey. And even Pants. Dog. I hope that dog's a Carolina Panthers fan. Because if he's not, he, she, or it is going to be pissed off. So there you go. That's a cute doggy. Woof. Ah! Let's drink. All right, folks. I think it's time for our first hunk of the day on Beer and Song of the Day. And got to start with the visiting team, the Arizona Cardinals. And there you go, from American Samoa, Mike Iupati, your hunk of the day, as we bring out Arizona's Cardinals theme song, YG remix. Here you go. Come on. There we go.
Arizona.
Cardinals. Now, yesterday, there were a lot of celebrity birthdays. So let's start talking. Christian Bale, former Hunk of the Day on Parent Song of the Day, folks. Christian Bale, you ladies and you men who love the men, love that guy. Great actor, 42 years old. Phil Collins, how about that guy? Longtime music icon Phil Collins. Milestone birthday. 65 years old as of yesterday. He's a senior citizen now. Kid Cudi, rapper. 32 years old. Franklin Delano Roosevelt, 32nd president of the United States of America. Got us out of the Depression. Democrat, one of the best presidents of all time. The only president in history that was elected to a third term and a fourth term before he passed away from polio. A brain hemorrhage brought on by polio. April 12, 1945, Warm Springs, Georgia. Franklin Delano Roosevelt was born in 1882 and an absolute icon. Incredible president. Danielle Campbell, hottie, 21 years old today. Guess what she can do? She can drink. Danielle Campbell, if you watch a beer song today, my dear, you're hot, real hot, damn hot. We're going to smoke it out. Let's drink. I like those third jerseys. Alternate jerseys, the black. Black Cardinal, that's kind of odd. Wilmer. Wilmer Valderrama. Oh, Valderrama. Phenomenal actor. 36 years old as of yesterday. Becky Lynch. Recently, Babe of the Day on Beer and Song Today. I love her. From Ireland. She's a hottie in WWE wrestling. And Becky Lynch is 29 and wicked fine. Abdullah II, the King of Jordan. This guy's phenomenal. He's a former Hunk of the Day on Beer and Song of the Day. He's 52 years old today. And he is out there fighting ISIS himself. And he's the king of a country. And he's stepping up and busting balls, taking names, kicking ass. Love it. King Abdullah II. You rock, brother. Big fan of that guy. Dick Martin, the old famous TV show Rowan and Martin's Laughing. Dick Martin, born in 1922, passed away at the age of 86 in 2008. Old Dick Cheney, whether you love that guy or hate him, he's a milestone 75 years old as of yesterday. The dude's had like 58 heart attacks or something. He's got a bad heart, but somehow he's still alive. Keeps on kicking. Dick, old Dick Cheney. Jalen Rose. Hey, NBA basketball player Jalen Rose. I remember him well. Yesterday, he turned 43 years old. Ironically enough, yesterday, I got a very dear friend of mine turned 43 years old. Awesome stuff. Gene Hackman. An incredible actor. Loved him as Popeye Doyle. French Connection. Gene Hackman, an incredible actor. Big fan of the guy. I can't believe it. He's 86 years old. Wow. Livia, the wife of Emperor Augustus of Rome. She was born on this day, or born yesterday, 58 BC. And she lived to the ripe old age of 87 years old and passed away in 29 AD. You know what that means? The NFC best. She could tell us if Jesus Christ was real. And I believe he was. I got Jesus in my heart, baby. Whether you do or don't, that's your choice. But I'll tell you what, I love Jesus. I do. Amen. Dorothy Malone, phenomenal actress. She yesterday turned 91 years old. That, my friends, deserves a look at the salute. Oh, hell yeah! Mike Iupati, American Samoa, 331 pounds of beast. Offensive lineman. Used to play with the San Francisco 49ers. I struggled to find pictures of him with the Cardinals. Cameron Wake. Phenomenal defensive end, Miami Dolphins. Cameron Wake, 34 years old as of yesterday. So there you go. There he is, the beast, Mike Iupati. Your hug of the day for the Arizona Cardinals. Let's drink. Oh, you know what we need? We need a Arizona Cardinals babe of the day on Beer and Song of the Day, don't we? Now, I try to put it out there to have a real babe of the day for the Cardinals and Panthers. Don't worry, folks. The Super Bowl is going to be covered very special. I'll give you that caveat now. But, hey, ain't nothing wrong with some hot eye candy right here. Arizona Cardinals got some beautiful cheerleaders. And this is Jackie, J-A-C-Q-U-E. I don't know how you pronounce that. Hey, you know, je ne peux pas français très bien. I don't speak French, but if I, you know, I don't speak French very well. But when I see J-A-C-Q-U-E, I think Jacques. But that's Jackie. And Arizona Cardinals fight song with this hot cheerleader, Jacque. She's hot, real hot, damn hot, with her and she's smoking hot. Better than you says so tired. Ain't she a beauty? Hey, yeah, damn right she is. So let's talk about today's celebrity birthdays on Beer and Song today as we look at some wonderful eye candy. Jackie of the Cardinals. We've got Justin Timberlake. Justin Timberlake, 35 years old today, and I am never going to forget what he did in Super Bowl 38 to Janet Jackson as my New England Patriots were playing against the Carolina Panthers. We all know about the boob scene around the world. Thank you, Justin Timberlake. I was never a fan of your music, but I'm a fan of you for what you did. Jackie Robinson. Phenomenal African-American. He is the one that broke the baseball's color barrier April 15, 1947. He was born this day in 1919. Sadly passed away much too young, only 53 years old in 1972. First black player elected to Baseball Hall of Fame, and rightfully so. An incredible icon, Jackie Robinson. Tyler Hubbard. Yeehaw country singer, 29 years old today, y'all. Portia de Rossi. I love this girl. Lesbian, hottie actress. And she's 43 years old today. I got friends of mine that are 43 years old today. Just like Portia de Rossi. Awesome. I love that name, too. Great name. Kerry Washington. You want to talk about a beautiful African-American actress? Oh, baby. Kerry Washington. 39 and wicked fine. Tyler Seguin. Pittsburgh Penguins phenomenal hockey player. 24 years old today. Nolan Ryan. Lynn Nolan Ryan. One of the most phenomenal major league pitchers of all time. Played for 27 seasons. That is a record. 5,714 strikeouts in his career. That's a record that will probably never be broken. Lynn Nolan Ryan is 69 years old today. Marcus Mumford. Mumford and Sons, that's right. Country folk group. Marcus Mumford, 29 years old today. Zane Grey, famous for Zane Grey Theater. Legendary author. Zane Grey, born this day in 1872, passed away in 1939. Vernon Davis, phenomenal tight end. Football player, Vernon Davis, 32 years old today. Minnie Driver, a cutie. The pride of Ireland, if I'm not mistaken. Cute actress. Minnie Driver. I'd be her driver. If I was single, of course. She's 46 years old today. Dick Gephardt. Remember him? Richard Gephardt. Dick Gephardt. 1984 presidential candidate. Senator from Iowa, if I'm not mistaken. Dick Gephardt. Milestone 75 years old today. awesome. Look at them Arizona Cardinals cheerleaders. Good God. Ernie Banks, Mr. Cub, played with the Chicago Cubs for all 19 seasons from 1953 to 71, 586 career home runs, and one of the classiest baseball players in history, Mr. Cub, Ernie Banks, born on this day in 1931, passed away, sadly, last year, 2015, at the age of 84. And I know Matt Mad Dog Becker. You love that guy. And I did, too. Johnny Rotten, real name John Lydon, L-Y-D-O-N, of the Sex Pistols, a milestone 60 years old today. Jeff Hanneman, oh, baby. Jeff Hanneman, we love you, from Slayer. Love Slayer. Phenomenal heavy metal band. Jeff Hanneman, guitarist for Slayer. Born on this day, 1964. Sadly passed away much too young, only 49 years old, in 2013. Jeff Hanneman, brother, you rock for life. Yeah, she gives you a salute too, you know. Just saying. Boy, we miss him. Legendary actress Tallulah Bankhead. Born on this day, 1902. Passed away in 1968. Damn, she looks great. Carol Channing. How about this one? Remember, you know that actress with that loud voice? Ah, yeah! Carol Channing, old school actress. I love her. Always a hilarious lady and always loud and proud. Carol Channing, get this, folks, a whopping 95 years old today. I don't know about you, but that deserves a big, and I've got to salute. Ooh, hell yeah. Ooh, hell yeah, indeed. And finally, Suzanne Pleshette. Loved her in the Bob Newhart show. Loved her in the movie Birds. She was so beautiful. Suzanne Pleshette. Beautiful brunette actress. Born on this day in 1937. Definitely a gift sent from heaven. Sadly passed away just short of 71 years old. Early in 2008. Miss Suzanne Pleshette. She was phenomenal. And that is phenomenal right there. All right, folks. With that said, it is time to represent some Carolina Panthers. That's right. Let's drink first. So, Carolina Panthers, earlier we had a trivia question about offensive lineman Michael Oher, O-H-E-R. Well, look at that, will you? There he is. That's right. Let's bring out some Carolina Panthers music for you. Petey Pablo, how about that, huh? Petey Pablo, brand new song, just made like a week ago, a couple weeks ago, Carolina Colors. This is the NFC Championship game hype, perfect for this show, and boy, they lived up to the hype. Carolina Panthers definitely lived up to the hype. There you go, Michael Oher. Former offensive lineman for the Baltimore Ravens. But I'll tell you what, it's most likely he's going to get a Super Bowl ring this year. I have a prediction. I'm going to keep an eye out, but right now, I think the Carolina Panthers are going to win the Super Bowl for the first time ever against a damn good Denver Broncos team. Both teams, two best teams. The two best defenses in the NFL this year. Carolina Panthers, Denver Broncos. No doubt about that. Trust me, I know about that defense for the Broncos. My Patriots got annihilated by them. They did. Straight up. Beat fan square. What? And look at that with the Tennessee Titans, Michael Oher. Blindside. You know, he's not a fan of the movie The Blindside. He'd rather not dwell on his negative experiences growing up. He's very humble. He just wants to go out there and have fun. And Cam Newton approves. And so does the Love Doctor. Michael Oher, phenomenal offensive lineman. But I do think the Carolina Panthers are going to beat the Denver Broncos. I do. Both teams, phenomenal defense. But I think the Panthers have a better offense because of this guy, Michael Oher. On a stage just last year, New Zealand professional golfer Lydia Ko, 17 years old, became the youngest number one ranked golfer in the world ever. She beat Tiger Woods' record that he set back in 1997 at the age of 21. When you're 17, you're number one in the world. That's amazing. Well, I say 1991, 25 years ago today, Denver Nuggets, Michael Adams becomes the shortest player in NBA history to get a triple-double. He was only 5'10", and still is, last I checked. What am I doing? All right. I forgot how... I only had 20 pictures of Michael Owen. All right. Much respect to Mike E. Patty. You know what? Much respect, bro. But that guy's going to Super Bowl. I want to say in 1990. I remember this like it was yesterday. 26 years ago today. The first McDonald's in Russia opens in Moscow. Folks, there were people in line for hours. It was huge. You're talking about a communist country that decided to go with something American. McDonald's. And that was the world's biggest McDonald's at the time, too. And I think it still is. I'm not sure, though. I don't know how popular they are nowadays. But boy, that was huge 26 years ago. All right, so we need to bring out the final song of the day and our baby today for the Carolina Panthers. We're going to bring out Carolina on the Rise, Carolina Panthers theme song, as we bring out a stunningly gorgeous cheerleader for the Carolina Panthers. Here you go, Myra. Oh, Myra, indeed. Look at her. She's hot, real hot, damn hot, wait on. Oh, so American hot. Finer than a new set of snow tires. Stunningly gorgeous. A lovely smile. Myra, Carolina Panthers cheerleader. RSA 1988, I remember watching the Super Bowl with my brother. Super Bowl 22, Washington Redskins quarterback, Doug Williams. Him and his Redskins beat the Denver Broncos 42-10 in San Diego. He was the Super Bowl MVP, the first African-American player to win a Super Bowl, Doug Williams, and he won MVP. Huge. Doug Williams was a class act in the NFL. He deserved that one. Well, I say 1981, The Tide Is High by Blondie with my girl Debbie Harry. Hits number one. Don't forget, the original version of The Tide Is High was done in 1965. Jamaican singer John Holt. Listen to that one sometime, you'll be blown away. Honest Day in 1976, Love Roller Coaster. Oh, God, I love that song by the Ohio Players. Hits number one 40 years ago today. Honest Day in 1974, McDonald's founder, Ray Kroc, buys the San Diego Padres. Wow. So he owned McDonald's and bought a baseball team, too. RSA 1968, Nauru, formerly known as Pleasant Island, declares independence from Australia. Nauru, happy Independence Day to you. 48 years old today. Also on the day in 1968, record high barometric pressure. 1,083.8 millibars, or 32 inches of mercury from my non-metric friend. Agata, Soviet Union. That is an all-time record. God, look at her. RSA 1965, the U.S. report, smoking and health, connects smoking to lung cancer. Oh boy. And smoking was always considered fashionable. I love this one. 55 years ago today, 1961. Ham, the first primate in space, 158 miles, aboard Mercury Redstone 2. In fact, back in February 2000, there was a movie filmed in Florida and also in California called The Race of Space with James Woods and Annabeth Gish and Bill Atherton. I know because I'm a background extra in that movie. And it was all about the race of space between the Soviets and the United States. That was an awesome movie and I was honored to be a part of it. You can see me clear as day in that movie. The Race of Space. Look it up. Fantastic family movie. On its day in 1958, U.S. launches their first artificial satellite, Explorer 1. On its day in 1955, RCA demonstrates the first music synthesizer. Uh-oh, told you the buzz would be coming soon. Oh, I say 1949, the first daytime soap opera on television. These are my children. Well, no shit. NBC in Chicago, Illinois. That's cute. Oh, I say 1948, magnetic tape recorder, developed by Wireway. Oh, I say 1936, the Green Hornet radio show was first heard on WXYZ radio in Detroit, Michigan. On this day, 1928, something we can all appreciate all around the world, Scotch tape is first marketed by the 3M company. On this day, 1916, 100 years ago today, the Dutch Girl Guides form. On this day, 1905, the first automobile to exceed 100 miles per hour, 161 kilometers per hour from a metric frenzy. And that was by A.G. McDonald, Daytona Beach, Florida. Wow. 1905, triple digits. How about that? Oh, man, that's hot. How about that? On this day in 1865, I love this one. Congress passes the 13th Amendment, abolishing slavery in America. And the votes were 121 to 24. So for the 24 people that were for slavery, you know what? Take that little GFY and shove it up your dead ass. That's a fine ass right there. Also on this day in 1865, ironically enough, General Robert E. Lee is named Commander-in-Chief of the Confederate Armies. Yep, don't worry. He lost. Less than three months later, April 9th, 1865, Appomattox, Virginia. Was it Virginia or Maryland? Appomattox, Virginia, I think it was. And finally on this day in 1851... You're going to love it. You're going to hate it. Gail Borden, he announces the invention of evaporated milk. I think it's a great invention. Without evaporated milk and condensed milk and all that stuff, I wouldn't have white chocolate raspberry cheesecake that my love goddess makes for me. Well, you know what, Gail Borden? Way to go, buddy. 165 years ago today. Awesome stuff. Let's drink a slam at home, shall we? Empty as the brain cells of an average Montreal Canadiens fan, eh? Folks, you know what time it is, right? Damn right, remember that to be. Folks, I'm making a fetus to head out. So everybody take care. We get an awesome night and day. Peace be the journey. Don't do anything I wouldn't do. Don't drink and drive. You might spray a drink. Or you might kill yourself or somebody else. And drinking and driving is dumber than being a Yankees fan. But what's dumber than that is being a fan of Justine. I should have been swallowed because I'm such a little bitch. Huh, no shit, you little bitch. Beaver! But what's something that throws men cyber women? Or animal abuse? Or racism? Or people who watch on pets? Or fake friends? Or anybody that supports fans as a member of the Westboro Baptist Church? Or ISIS? Things like that are just plain stupid. And definitely deserve a big, fat GFY! First of all, I'll see you all tomorrow on Blues Monday. It's going to be epic. First football Sunday show under an hour. And under 50 minutes, for that matter. In God only knows how long. But I'll talk to you later. Time to watch the Pro Bowl and eat like a king. Talk to you later. Bye-bye.